Hello everyone, I am going to work on my resin coffee table again, and I am first going to fill in the gaps that I have. So I'm starting with a very dark color, the Muddy Seas. I'm using the same colors as the first layer, but only a little bit more transparent colors so that the first layer can shine through. But first, the gaps. On top of the Muddy Seas, I'm pouring some white of Stone Coat. And above that, the Reef Blue of Color Obsession. Very nice and sparkly color. And with my steering stick, I push the resin against each other. The first layer dried very well, or the parts of the first layer dried very well. So, I'm pushing the resin against that part. Now a little bit of heat to see which effects I can get. So I'm trying to push those colors over the white. Maybe I get some cells, who knows? And what I'm also trying to do in this video or in this layer is to give the sun a little bit more definition, or what must resemble the sun. Again, the Muddy Seas of Color Obsession. And this white of Stone Coat above it. And the Reef Blue also from Color Obsession. And again, with my steering stick, I push the resin against each other. And I must say, the Stone Coat dried very well. It looks like glass, and that's what I like about resin. Again, some heat, because the white needs to resemble the foam on the waves. So again, I'm trying to push the color over the white. And again, a line of the darker blue color. And some white. Again, I'm using two whites. One is the Angel White of Lares, where I mix some sparkle pearl of Color Obsession in it, so that it gets a lot of sparkle. And the other white is from Stone Coat. again some heat to blend those colors. Yeah, and I must say this art coat of stone coat doesn't need much heat to move it around. That's a little bit different with the MasterCards. You need to heat it up for quite some time before you can move it around. But this is, I like it because it's much easier to create some effects. So all the parts in the water are filled now. And now I'm adding a transparent orange. That's the flame orange of Resitint, of Eli Gem. And a little bit of white. And that's the saffron of Just Resin. And again, I'm going to blend those colors. Because I want my sunset to have all different shades of orange. Again, the saffron. And this is the orange peel of Color Art Primary Elements. Very sparkly color. And again, I'm going to blend those colors. Now I'm going to work on the what needs to resemble the sun. So first a little bit of bright yellow. That's a very opaque color. Around it some stone coat white. Also a little bit. And this is the yellow of Eli Gem. That's an ink, very transparent. So I hope that the first layer shines through. And again, some white around it. And a little bit of orange, the flame orange. Now I'm going to heat it. To make it a little bit bigger. And now again some bright yellow around it, the transparent yellow. And around that, again, the stone coat white. And orange. again some heat to see what kind of effects I'm getting. So I'm trying to blow the yellow over the white and over the orange. Some white around it, and that's the Angel White of Lures with a lot of sparkle in it. Yeah, and these are all transparent colors, so you can see the first layer shining through, but yeah, in the video that's not really, you can't really see it. Heating it up again, blowing the orange over the white, then you get a different shade of orange. I like that. Again, some transparent yellow. A little bit of white. And so I'm building this layer up with all bright colors. And I'm not covering the whole first layer with other colors, because some parts I like really much, so I leave them. Now I'm going to add a white line that is on the border of the water and of the sky. Because if you have the reflection on the sun on the water, then you have also a very bright color. So I will add very small, fine white lines on top of the blue that needs to resemble the reflection of the sun in the water. And I do nothing, I give it no heat, I want it to stay as it is, so that I have very small white stripes. And this is not the stone coat white, but this is the angel white of Lures with a sparkle in it. So I hope that it will sparkle a lot if I have it outside and the sun shines on it. A little bit of yellow. So and now we can go to the close-up and you can see if it changed or not. So after I was done filming, I wasn't really satisfied with the sun, so I changed it a little bit. And you will see it in a moment. But first the water part. It's all filled now. I'm very happy what I have now. And also a lot of cells. I like it. I didn't do anything about the black part. That will be the next step. That I add some definition to that part. But there you can see the water part. And what I added. And also all the cells I got. And that's because of the stone coat. So if you want to have cells or lacing, buy that pigment, it's very good. and the colors have blended nicely. I'm pleased with this. So there you see the part of the sun, and so you can see I poked with a steering stick through the colors so that I can resemble the beams of the sun. I think it's called beams. So the reflection of it. And also there in the water where I did the small white stripes. Yeah, I like it. It's nice. A little bit closer. So this is what I not done anything about it. So it's still the same. But it's really, really nice. Nice cells or lacing or how do you want to call it. But I like it. Sparkles a lot. So the whole second layer is almost filled now. But there are some parts that are still the first layer, but I will leave them because I like it. And in the next part, I think I'm going to use some acrylic markers. I don't know yet, but I think because when I use them or some acrylic paint, I can define some areas a little bit more. This part I added. I got some really nice effects. Also some cells. Yeah, I'm happy with this. So what I already said, I'm going to work on the black part and maybe use some acrylic markers for the skyline. But yeah, I need to think about it. A little bit closer. There you see all the little white stripes I added. Must resemble the reflection of the sun on the waves. Also the cells. Very nice. Also the reflection of the sun in the water, but then not white, but then with a kind of yellow color, but it, because it's not all white. There you can see that I used my steering stick. Yeah, that's much, much better. There I added the orange and the yellow to make it a little bit more brighter. Little bit closer where you can see where I use my steering stick. So this was part 2, and if you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. If you have tips or comments or questions, place them under the video or send me an email. All the links you need to know are in the description box, also where I buy my materials. And where you can find me on Facebook and Instagram. Give me a thumbs up if you like what I'm doing. And I will all see you in the next video. And also thank you for watching. Bye.